Here's your latest weather briefing from the National Weather Service in San Diego. This is Alex Tardy, the Warning Coordination Meteorologist. Please send feedback directly to the email listed here. The topic of this video briefing is the Santa Ana winds that are expected with the change in the weather pattern and a significant warming trend developing all the way through next week. This presentation is about 3 minutes long. All right, here's a look at the highlights that we are expecting with these offshore flow winds. First off, we're going to see onshore flow or westerly sea breeze winds on Saturday ahead of the system. Then the offshore will quickly develop, or the northeast winds, Saturday night and increasing through Sunday. It'll last in San Diego County the longest, Sunday night all the way through Monday morning. We'll see locally strong winds for the Inland Empire, downwind of the Cajon Pass for areas such as Fontana and Rancho Cucamonga, and the Santa Ana foothills, which impacts I-15 all the way down to SR-91, as well as the San Gregorio Pass, which is primarily Interstate 10, but also all the way down to I-215. Wind shifts in San Diego County will occur on Sunday, impacting I-8 and SR-78, and this will continue through Sunday night into Monday, at least Monday morning. Wind gusts in these areas mentioned above could exceed 55 miles per hour at times from Saturday night all the way through Sunday night. Significant warming will result from these winds. The trend will start Monday and be quite significant all the way through Thursday. We'll see offshore flow increasing again for mid next week as high pressure gets stronger over the Great Basin. All right, let's look at graphically what the areas are that we're talking about here. As shown in this map, the areas in orange, those are the areas downwind of the Cajon Pass, affecting areas from Fontana all the way down to perhaps near Santa Ana, certainly in Tustin. Then when we look over the San Gregorio Pass, areas around Banning down to near Hemet, and also potentially clipping areas of I-215 up near San Bernardino. Now further down in San Diego, we're going to see the winds, especially for Sunday afternoon and Sunday night, in the red area. That'll impact areas along Highway 78 and then eventually down to Interstate 8 passes. All right, what's causing this? Well, in an offshore wind event or Santa Ana wind event, we typically see high pressure area at the surface near ground level moving across northern Nevada and into Utah. That's what's going to develop on Sunday behind the weather system that goes well to our east and north. And we're going to see this happen again, likely for middle of next week, with potentially a stronger high pressure area at the surface moving across the Great Basin region. All right, the jet stream. This is what drives these storm systems. Recently, in early to mid-February, the jet stream was in the same position, but it was further south and moving across Southern California. For this weekend and next week, it's going to retreat to the north, and as shown here, the disturbance on Sunday and Monday is going to go by well to our east and result in that big high pressure that'll settle in behind it. That will bring our offshore Santa Ana winds. All right, here are some links I'd like you to take a look at if you haven't already for monitoring wind, weather, and rain when we do get it. Weather.gov San Diego is our webpage for any watches, advisories, and warnings that may be issued pertaining to the wind that is coming up in the forecast. Also, check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and of course, this video is on YouTube. Please send feedback. We appreciate your time.